Hey, welcome to this video about how to solve sexual problems, how to solve problems in your sexual life. This is something that every single couple will go through. If you're in a long-term relationship or if you want to go into a long-term relationship with someone, you're going to have to face these problems because they're going to arise. As I've mentioned in many of the videos, you know, when we start the relationship, when we start a sexual relationship, everything is great. You know, we are full of dopamine, we are drugged, we are in our high of love, and we don't really know anything, and we just have sex, and everything is great. And what happens when that's over, when that high is over, you start to be yourself. You start to be who you really are, and your sex drive starts to come up, starts to show, your sex preferences start to show, the real ones, I mean. And that's when everything starts. That's when the work starts. That's where you have to really start solving issues that are going to come up. Because what happens is, well, it used to be like that. Now it's not like that. So what's real and what's not? And many couples don't address these issues. What they do is they just put them under the carpet and they say, well, I'll talk about it later. Well, maybe it's me, or well, maybe he has a problem or she has a problem. I'm not going to talk about it. Many people think it's better to leave it there. And that's really a big mistake. If you have an issue in your sexual life, you have to talk about it fast, and you cannot leave it there, because resentment starts to build up. Rage starts to build up. Actually, problems starts to mix, because you might have other problems with your partner. Maybe you have economic problems, or maybe you have problems with your kids, and that sexual problem will start to explode because of those other problems as well. And that resentment starts to build up inside you. And I've been there. I know how it works like that. And if you don't speak about it, it can really build up. And once it builds up and it goes over the top, it can come to a point of no return. It can come to a point where you have, it's really difficult to overcome the problem, because you're so full of rage. It takes a big exercise of you forgiving the other person and forgiving yourself about what has happened and about how you can solve the issue. Because really, guys, if there's any emotional issue with sex, it's going to show up. And at one point, you're going to have to address it. And the sooner, the better. So if you're in a situation right now where that's happening to you, you need to start talking about it. And if you are starting to have that problem, maybe you're starting to feel strange in your sexual life, your sexual life is not like you like to be, start talking now before it's too late. Because when it's too late, it takes a lot more effort, it takes a lot more time, and it takes a lot more energy to actually solve this problem. Actually, it might take that you have to go to a counseling, you have to go to someone that can actually help you, a third person that can help you. I'm here to help you, and I am trying to encourage you to really talk about it. Communication is the key for a great sex life. You need to talk all the time, constantly. You need to evaluate your sexual life all the time. And speak when you don't feel good, when something's not right. Speak about it. The first rule to solve the problem, and this rule is imperative. This is something that you have to do. You have to start with yourself. You have to start thinking and meditating on what you can do to improve your sexual life. What you can do to make that work. What you can do to make that other person be satisfied in bed. You start with you. You don't start blaming the other person. You start with yourself. What can you do? What have I done wrong? If you start the conversation saying, you have done this to me, you have done that to me, you are not like that, you were doing that before and now you're not doing it. If you start blaming the other person, he or she is going to feel attacked and they're going to close and nothing is going to happen. That's the way it works. That's the way it works. So if you start blaming, you're not going to solve anything. So the first thing you have to do is talk and find a place that's neutral, that you feel comfortable, both of you. Maybe you have to go outside your house. Maybe you have to book a hotel or book a place somewhere where you can sit. No distractions, no phone, and speak about this. And maybe I'm talking about when you already have a big problem, okay? If you're having, little issues, you can talk that anytime. But if you're having a big problem, one of you have to take that first step and say, hey, we need to talk about this. We need to talk about our sexual life. We need to solve this before it goes too deep and before it goes to the point of no return. This is something you have to do. So one of you have to do and be brave enough to do it. Find a place where it's neutral, that you can feel relaxed, that nobody's going to bother you, no kids if you have kids, no phones, of course, no distractions, and talk about it. Go deep. But start with you. Say, hey, what can I do to make you feel better? What can I do to make you be happier? Start with that. The conversation has to start with that. Hey, what have I done wrong that has come to this position, this situation where we are right now? Of course, it's a we situation. It's both of you. But you have to start with you. Because we always blame other people for us, for not making us happy. And that's the biggest mistake about love. If you see my videos here, you know, love is not about waiting for someone to make you happy. You have to be happy on your own. You cannot expect that someone's going to make you happy or is going to satisfy you in bed. You have to find that way. That person is going to go with you, is going to walk with you, and is going to be with you in that journey, but he or she is not responsible for that. You are responsible for that. And if you're not happy, you have to tell that person, hey, I don't like this. I'm not feeling good about this. That's how it starts, okay? So make sure you start that conversation and you start with you. I hope that comes across, because this is so important if you want to solve the situation. Because if not, you're going to have to go to counseling. You're going to have to go and get a marriage counselor that can help you, a third person that can help you, because you will need that. And it's a pity, because sometimes there's love and there's respect, but sex is not working because you're not working on it. And as I've said in many videos, I don't want to repeat myself, but when you go over that high, over that being in love and everything is great, is when everything starts. And sex is work. Having a great sex life is work. You must work on it every day, every week. You must schedule your sex every week. You have to plan it, because if not, it's not going to happen. If you leave having sex to chance, or like when I feel horny, it's not going to happen. Because yes, you're going to have sex every now and then. But it would come to a point after 15 years where you're going to get bored. And I'm going to talk about that now. I'm going to talk about some of the reasons why this happens and how you can avoid that, how you can solve it. But really, you must work on it. And there's no other way of doing this. If you want to be in a long-term relationship with your partner, you must work on it and make it fun, make it a game, make it something that you really like to do. But it must be part of your planning. It must be part of your if during the week you plan where you're going to go buy groceries. I'm going to do a very simple comparison. But if you're going to do a planning of you're going to do groceries, I'm going to do this, I'm going to go out with my friends, I'm going to go with the kids somewhere. You plan that, right? Okay, well, you have to plan sex as well. And I'm not saying, okay, at 6 o'clock on Saturday, we're going to have sex. Not, I'm not talking about that. But you have to say, okay, this week, I want to have sex one day of the week. And plan it and say, okay, I'm going to give these 3 hours to have sex. Why not? Find it. There's videos here on how to do that. Okay, I'm not going to repeat myself again. But this is very important. Sex is about giving and receiving. Like any other relationship, any type of relationship is about giving and receiving. And you have to give in order to receive. That's the key. And if you're both not giving and receiving to each other, it's not going to work. Go in that conversation with a very humble attitude, with a very positive attitude to make things work. If you don't do it, if you cannot do it, really, you have to go get some counseling, really. If you cannot make yourself go, if the resentment is so big, you cannot do it, go and get help. Because maybe the relationship is over. It can be over, yes, of course. If you leave it too much for too long, it can be over. So let me share with you some of the problems that arise in sexual life, like the most common ones. There can be others, of course, more problems than maybe you're experiencing. I'm going to cover some of them. But at the end, as I said, at the end, it's a matter of talking about it and trying to solve it. One of the biggest problems that happens is that people are very tired. They have no time to have sex. And that's one of the biggest claims that many people say, hey, I don't have time to have sex. I'm so tired after the day, after going to work, and then I have to do so many responsibilities. And if you have kids, imagine, we have so many things to do during the day, 40 plus hour weeks of work. Some people work on the weekends as well. And there's so many things to do that when it comes to sex, we're so tired. It's like, whoa, now I have to have sex? I'm so tired. That's why I talked about planning. And that's why I want you to solve this issue. First, you need to schedule your week better. Schedule it better. If you're working too much, make sure you work less. You have to work less. You have to work enough hours that you can do your job, of course, but you have to work less because your life is going to explode if not. I mean, it makes no sense to be working all day just to make money when you cannot enjoy the money and enjoy the time that you have to be with your partner or be with your family. If you're too tired or you don't have time to have sex, you must find that time, because if not, it's not going to work. So make sure you schedule your week better and schedule sex within that week. Another common issue is boredom. Boredom in the bedroom. This is one of the most common ones. Once you've been together for a while, for several years with your partner, you start to get bored. And yes, of course, that's normal. But you have to find ways to make it fun and make it a game. There's a video in this course about that. So just find ways, fantasies, things to do to spice up your sex life. There's many things you can do. But boredom, yes, it's a problem. And if you start getting bored, you need to talk about it. You need to talk about it. You say, hey, I'm getting bored. Let's do something before it's too late. Another very common problem, of course, is not being satisfied in bed, not being happy in bed, not having orgasms. If a couple are having sex and one of them is not enjoying himself or herself and they're not having orgasms, they're going to stop wanting to have sex. That's as simple as that. If one of you is not enjoying sex, that person is going to stop having it. It's going to say, I don't want to have this. This is too much. And if you have other issues in your relationship, that's going to explode big time. So if you're not having a happy sexual life, if you're not having orgasms, if you're not satisfied sexually in your sexual life, make sure you speak and say, I'm not happy, I don't like it. And the other person has to take it not as a blame, not as you're responsible for it. Let's find a way together. It's a matter of finding a way together. If there's love, you'll find a way. If there's love, you will find a way. If there's love and respect, you can find a way for sure. Another one is frequency. And this is a big one, big one, big one, frequency. Normally, what happens at the beginning, you have sex all the time. When you go back to normal, your sex drive, your real sex drive shows, okay? If you have a very high sex drive, you keep wanting to have sex all the time. If you have a low sex drive, you want to have less sex. Now, what happens, sometimes you fall in love with someone and maybe your sex drives don't match. That can happen, and that's normal, and that's nothing, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's normal. It's like, you know, I like to sleep more than the other person. I like to go to the beach and I like to go to the mountains. You don't have to be the same. You don't have to agree on everything. Even on sex, you don't have to agree. So frequency, it's an issue, can be an issue. Now, if the guy, normally the guy wants to have more sex with the girl, and that's in general, okay? It happens like that. You have to find that balance. You know, you both have to be happy. And you have to find the balance, okay? And you can find that balance by talking about it and say, hey, are you happy with how much sex we're having? Yes, I'm good. Okay, just to put the example, okay? Imagine that the guy has a very high sex drive and the girl doesn't have it so much. And he wants to have sex all the time. And she doesn't want to. And she might get really annoyed by having to have sex all the time and she doesn't really want to have it. She might get bored and she might get tired of doing it. Now, the guy has to find his balance through masturbation. Yes, through masturbation. Find your balance. If you need to masturbate to satisfy yourself, do it. And have sex and find that balance. It's a matter of talking. It's a matter of saying, hey, are you happy with this? Are you happy how much sex we're having? When you talk about it, and if both of you are honest and speak the truth about it, you will find a way. And find that balance of frequency. If one has high and one has low, find a balance. Talk about it. But you don't have to say, okay, we don't match, we have to split. It doesn't have to be like that. Okay, if you cannot find a way or a solution, maybe you have to split. But it doesn't have to be that way. Because trying to find the perfect match is not easy. And we are all different. And we're not always going to be the same. Another common problem is preferences, like tastes in sex. Maybe You know, maybe the guy likes to have rough sex all the time. The girl doesn't want to have rough sex all the time. She wants to also have slow sex. And maybe I like blowjobs better than she does. And I like oral sex more. You know, there's all kinds of preference. I like this fantasy. She doesn't like this fantasy. I don't know. There's so many things that may not match. This is another issue that makes problems arise, because if the guy, for example, wants to have all these fantasies and she doesn't want to, it comes to a point where he can get frustrated. So again, here you have to find that balance where you talk about it and say, hey, I would love to do all these things, and negotiate. You have to negotiate. This is a negotiation. Sometimes in our relationships, we have to negotiate what we want to do or not, because it's not like saying, well, I don't like it, I'm not going to do it ever. And find your way, or I don't care what you think, because that way nothing is going to be solved. You have to find that balance. And if you cannot find that balance, probably your relationship is going to break. It's going to go bust. So if you really love that person and you want to be with that person, find that balance. Find a way where you can be comfortable with doing the things he likes and he can be comfortable doing the things she likes. You have to find that balance. And the only way to find a balance is talking and agreeing and making sure that you make that agreement and everyone is happy. And you always make sure that you talk about it all the time. You evaluate this all the time. You must do this. Another problem, the last one I'm going to talk about here today, is probably children, family. Family and children can create a serious problem in the sexual relationships, because they take so much time and so much attention that really hurts the sex life. And that's something you have to accept as well, okay? You must accept that, because you know, you have 24 hours a day, and at the beginning you're always together, and you have all the time that's extra. You know, you go to work, and then you have extra time that you spend with your couple. Now you have to share that time with your family, your kids, and many other things. So there's 24 hours, and that's the time you have, and you have to share it with everyone you love and everything you want to do in life. So it's going to affect it. It's going to affect your sexual life when you have children. But you have to find a way to make sure that both of you are happy with the sex life you're having, that sex life doesn't die, that these problems don't arise. Because if they arise and they start to go under the carpet, which happens a lot when children come, we were like, oh, family is the most important thing, and we forget about the couple. We start thinking about our children more than anything, and that's normal. It's natural. It's human. But what happens is that you forget about the couple, and 5 years or 10 years down the road, you're like, okay, who's this person I'm with? I don't have sex anymore. I don't really know that person so much anymore, because we're so busy. So you need to focus. You need to give time. You need to make sure you schedule time together. And not only sex, romantic, go out to dinner and make sure you do things together that hold that couple together. This is so important, because if not, all these sexual problems are going to arise. I don't want to make this video any longer. Really, this is very important. It's very important that you talk. Communication is the key here. It's very important that you go with a humble attitude and that you focus on yourself. Don't focus on what the other person is not doing. Focus on what you can do. Because when I go with that attitude, things totally change. If I go into a conversation with someone saying, hey, what can I do to help you out? What can I do to make this better? The other person is going to go, wow. Because we are used to go into a conversation and blaming the other person and accusing and saying, you. And that's a problem that we have. We cannot just go there accusing. We have to start with ourselves. And yes, of course, there's things that other people might do that we don't like, but we have to say, hey, I don't like when you do that. It's simple like that. I don't like it. I just don't like it. With all the respect, I don't like it. But don't blame that other person for not being happy. The only person that's responsible for your happiness is you. It's not any other person, it's you. So speak up, say, I want this. This is what I like. What can I do to make this work? That's how it works. Okay, so I hope this serves. I hope this helps you out with your sexual relationships, and I will see you in the next video.